Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I'm not sure if you recall, if you have seen all the videos, probably not, but a long time ago I showed you some PSLK knife, which is a inspiration, not a special clone of the Survive. I think it's Survive 5.1, something like that, which was really well made in 14C28N and comfortable. And I mean, I like that knife. Just that steel is good for a small knife. It's not perfect for very hard knives you want to batten or stuff like that. It's mainly soft steel, not too hard steel. It's 28, I think, HRC, which is common in many of the knife, and it's still okay. But and that knife was cool, and they have released on AliExpress recently, is AGF doing it, the biggest version, which is the 7.7 version of the Survive GSO. So that's the version made by HGF. I think I got one of the first production because obviously this one has some small minor default. So defects. So I will go through it and you will let me know what you think. I think I like it. I paid that 100 euro. Maybe a little bit cheaper. I'm not sure how much I paid that, but yeah. I can check the price and put you in comment if you're interested, but I think it's still available on Ali. I got a price from the vendor and I think I paid that below 100 euro. So I'm not sure if it's 80 or 90 or 100, but something like that. Whatever. You have very nice Micarta handle. I take it out recently, and inside they cut a part of the metal to have the knife lighter. So if you take it out, I will not do it during that vid, but you can see that here, they took out a part of the metal. Three parts of the metal are missing. So, I mean, maybe here, here, and another way to make sure that the knife is lighter and to put the proper balance on the knife. You have a nice finger hole here, nice jumping, well made. Very nice blade in A8. You can see it's A8 steel. I like A8 steel. The only cons I have on that stuff is on the bottom. You can see that first of all, it's not very well adjusted. Here, you have more space between the handle and the blade than here. I don't think it's on purpose. I think that they should have polished a little bit more the handle on that side. So I think it's a kind of default. You can see it here. And the second issue I have, you can from here, for example, this one is better adjusted. This one is perfectly adjusted. And the second default I have, this is here, you have a lanyard hole. You can see you can put a lanyard hole. In the original version, you have a lanyard hole. In their version, there is nothing. You cannot put any lanyard hole. And even I took out the handle because I was wanting to melt it myself and do a hole here so I can put a lanyard hole, but there is no hole in the middle actually. The hole is too high. So you cannot put any handle. So that stuff, you just have to use it. And I think it's a little bit bad because they should have done the same system as here because it's a good idea. So at the end, still for the price, I'm pretty satisfied because the Survive GSO 7.7 is pretty expensive and this one is cool. The sheath now. Sheath is as the original with a big hole in the middle. So you can take out the water. The only thing they have added is that belt loop with laser strap, which I think is cool. And you can take it out if you don't like it. Well securing the knife, no play at all. So sheath is good, thick kydex. Nice thumb one, getting in and out easily. Oh, that stuff is really, really, really good. I just got it, so it's not used yet, but it's quite sharp. And I will love the materials of the handle. I mean, that Micarta is really high quality. The only small stuff I have, this is the bottom of the knife, which is, you can use that as a hammer. I don't know why they didn't do it properly with the lanyard hole and everything. I mean, that's a little bit stupid when you think about it, because it was not so costly. And that at all, they will get a very, very nice high-end knife. That stuff is taking out a little bit something on the knife to not have it. Whatever, at the end, it's still a cool knife for the price, and it's still available on Ali, so you can go for it if you want. It's done by Godfrey, which is AGF again, so that's the same. That's one of their brand they have in their factory. Let's look at the spec of that one now. So people may be interested to see where is my stuff. So we have 16.5 centimeters long blade, 18 to the handle, a little bit more than 18, 31, a little bit more than 20, 31.5 overall size. You have a 4 centimeters wide, and the thickness now is, yeah, 6 millimeters thickness. And you can see that it's going to the end. You still have 6 millimeters thickness until that part of the blade, which is almost the end. So it's almost impossible to break the tip. Nice finger choil here, so you can use it for close work. At the end, I think that if you don't have the cash to buy the original Survive, that one is a good alternative. It's really well made. I hate it's good. The Micarta is really, really, really nice. I mean, that you can see in more detail, but it's a very nice Micarta. It's really comfortable in hand. I mean, that's better than G10 for me. Because you don't have any lanyard hole, but with the shape of the handle, it's really comfortable. And it's not too big knife. I mean, it's not a crazy knife that you need for sure a lanyard hole. You can really use it this way. And as it's not slippery at all with the Micarta, even if you do some buttoning or whatever, you can keep it. The sheath is great. The knife is great. Let's look at the weight. Okay. 450. And with the sheath, you go at 612. So yeah, 460, I mean that 450 for that knife. It's a heavy knife, to be honest. When you have it in hand, you feel secure, you feel comfortable. I like it. I mean that with that one on the smallest browser, yeah, definitely that's a good catch. This one is good. So that's all I can tell you on that one today. You tell me what you think about that bottom on the bottom part. For me, it's not like it's for the price, it's still okay. That's all for today. Thanks, guys. Bye bye.